blood and metal.
You talking to me? Well, then who the hell else are you talking? You talking to me? Well, I'm the only one here. Who the fuck do you think you're talking to? Oh, yeah? Huh? Okay. Huh? Listen, you fuckers, you screwheads. Here is a man who would not take it anymore. Who would not.
Ah, little lad, you're staring at my fingers. Would you like me to tell you the little story of right hand, left hand? The story of good and evil? H-A-T-E. It was with this left hand that old brother Cain struck the blow that laid his brother low. L-O-V-E. You see these fingers, dear hearts, these fingers has veins that run straight to the soul of man. The right hand, friends, the hand of love. Now watch and I'll show you the story of life. These fingers, dear hearts, is always a warring and a tugging, one against the other. Now watch them. Old brother left hand hates a fighting, and it looks like love's a goner. But wait a minute. Wait a minute. Dog loves a winning. Yes, sirree. It's love that won. And old left hand hate is down for the count.
Show him around, tell him the TV rules, show him the games and stuff, okay?
How much you gonna pay me? How much? I'd be doing your job.
$5,000, my man. That enough?
$5,000?
I wire a check to your account as usual.
$5,000. $5,000.
$5,000.
I'll give him the deluxe mental hospital tour.
My man.
Kid around, makes him feel good. Yeah, pals. You're the prisoners. No, you're the guards.
Now you got it.
Okay. It's all in good fun. Here's some games here, and there's. Get out! He was in my chair. Games. Here's some games. Games that want to get out. See? More games. Games, they vegetize you. See? Yeah. If you play the games, you're voluntarily taking a tranquilizer. I guess they give you some chemical restraints, huh? Drugs! What did they give you? Thorazine? Haldol? How much? Learn your drugs. Know your doses. It's elementary.
I need to make a telephone call.
Telephone call? That's communication with the outside world. Doctor's discretion. Hey, all of these nuts could just make phone calls. They could spread insanity oozing through telephone cables, oozing to the ears of all these poor, sane people, infecting them. Wackos everywhere, plague of madness.
Come on, let's go.
In fact, very few of us here are actually mentally ill. I'm not saying you're not mentally ill. For all I know, you're crazy as a loon. But that's not why you're here. It's not why you're here. You're here because of the system. There's the television. It's all right there. Look, listen, kneel, pray. Commercials. We're not productive anymore, at least to make things anymore. It's all automated. What are we for then? We're consumers, Jim. Okay. Buy a lot of stuff, you're a good citizen. But if you don't buy a lot of stuff, what are you then, I ask you? What? Mentally ill. Back, Jim, back. If you don't buy things, toilet paper, new cars, computerized blenders, electrically operated sexual devices, stereo systems with brain-implanted headphones, screwdrivers, miniature built-in radar devices, voice-activated computers.
Take it easy, Jeffrey. Be calm.
Right. That's right. You're a very attractive woman. So, if you want to watch a particular television program, say, it's all my children or something, you go to the charge nurse, you tell the day, the time, the show you want to see is on. But you have to tell her before the show is scheduled to be on. There's this guy, and he was always requesting shows that had already played. Yes. No. You have to tell her before. He couldn't quite grasp the idea that the charge nurse couldn't make it be yesterday. She couldn't turn back time. Thank you, Einstein. Now, he was nuts. He was a fruitcake,
okay,
Jim.
That's it, Jeffrey. You're gonna get a shot. I warned you.
Right. I got a little carried away explaining the inner workings of the institution to Jim.
It's amusing to me to torture a cop. You can say anything you want, because I've heard it all before. All you can do is pray for a quick death. Which you ain't gonna get. Listen to Kay Billy's Super Sounds of the 70s.
It's my personal favorite.
Joe Egan and Jerry Rafferty were a duo known as Dealer's Wheel when they recorded this Dylan-esque pop bubblegum favorite from April of 1974. That reached up to number five as K. Billy Super Sounds of the 70s continued.
Don't go anywhere, I'll be right back.